first match would have been in September after we had our first meeting in April. So the following September we had our first match. But we had to do a lot of research work in the meantime, because we had to get approval from the county board to establish the club. Then we had to show that we could actually run the club as well. But because you had people with a lot of, I suppose, GA background, I don't think the county board had any doubt about our capability to set up and run a club. So that took about probably about 3 months, really,
yes,
from start to finish to get that admitted to the county board.
At the time, we were very anxious because we were having weekly meetings, but the county board only met once a month. So from May, June, July, the three meetings, and if we didn't get over the hurdle, say, in July, we wouldn't be allowed to enter teams for September, so we'd lose the following year. We would have gone. So when we heard we were going to be opposed, I canvassed, I made a point, I rang the county, the club secretaries of the other clubs to make sure they'd back us up. So when the crucial vote came, it just went straight through. So we needed that boost and we took it from there. So 6 weeks later, about 6 weeks later, we had the three teams. And that photograph there, I can identify the children without looking at the names. They're still in the club. And that was taken, I think, the second week. And there's three of them there who played county. So that's a good sign of our success, isn't it?
Well, I moved into the area in 97 and got married, and I was involved with a club down in Wexford called Tower Rocks, and it was a long way to commute for junior football, and one of my neighbours, Donald Cunningham, still involved here, asked me would I play, and didn't think I'd get a nice bunch of lads, so I ended up playing with them for a couple of years and just liked it and couldn't be a nicer lad, so I stayed with them, hence I'm still here. It's a great community in it, and it's good fun. It's beginning to build. You find in areas in Dublin where people don't know anybody, and an awful lot of people from the country are up here and in the area. No one knows anyone from Adam, and there's a lot of schools, kids don't intermix. Getting a community spirit.
I chose Castleknock through one of the guys at work. Basically said there was a new club. I live locally here, and this guy said there's a new club starting up. Would I get involved in helping out? And I said I wouldn't initially until my child was probably 5 or 6 years old, and then I went up to the nursery and stayed at it, and I looked after the nursery for about 3 years, helped out there, and then I moved on to Camogie, which would be my first love. I'd like to see this club continue on the path that they're currently on, an inclusive club. Regardless of ability, all children get a shot at playing, and we bring them out, get them playing, and if they win something, great. But having, regardless of ability, get them out, get them playing, keeping them playing, and hopefully we'll have a senior Camogie team, hopefully we'll have a senior football team, but if we don't, we don't. And I think that, you know, getting the maximum number of people playing is the aim, and having the sense of community, having all the various other activities like score, you know, the quizzes, the social side of it.
When I look around me on a Saturday or a Sunday or indeed during the week and see the amount of young kids and the enjoyment they get out of the club,
if you go anywhere you go on a Saturday, any day of the week really, but especially Saturday morning, there's such a buzz up around the school there, Castleknock Community College.
And the friends I've met, I mean, there's a huge amount of new people I'd never have met if I hadn't joined Castleknock GA. We go away on weekends, we great fun at matches, we fall out and we fall back in, but overall we're all great friends.
What's the sense of involvement, the sense of community, comradeship? And met a lot of good friends. I mean, you walk into the shop or, heaven forbid, the local pub and you meet someone that you know. Prior to me being involved in the club, that wouldn't have probably happened.
The club, the people, mainly the people involved, because a club's nothing without the people at the end of the day.